So as of now, I've given out 10 blackouts, and Creed's one of them. And most of you know, since all of your students here know that my philosophy for jiu-jitsu is that we need to focus on fundamentals, and the more fundamental it is, the more freedom the student has to develop his own game, the faster he can. And so the whole, the game of black belt and the game for coaches is all about parsing, trying to explain as much as possible, as simply as possible, so that you guys can get it and move on and start growing your game. And I don't think anybody has done that better than Creed so far. So I think you guys are in for a treat. I'd be on Matt Tranley, except I have to go to my son's graduation, but I'll be here tomorrow. So having said that, it's all you.
Thank you. So this material is 7 months old. Now I can say I'm open guard. I actually like to say that before I even can't remember what I did before that. It was still like an attack and I had a guard, but now I know why it works, and also passing has got better. So my trigger point was 13 and a half years frustration. And it's about the question, but when you can ask actually the right question. It took me 13.5 years to actually ask for something they want to ask. I tried to teach people open guard. They didn't get it. You know, I was trying to teach them the arribas, you know, Brazilian sweeps from there, everybody picked one. Still open guard wasn't that good. I was trying to have spider guards and everything, just to give people like those option possibilities. But people didn't develop open guard that quickly actually. Some figured out, but some didn't. And it was always just kind of considered my fault. And then there had to be something before all the arribas and all the spiders and it, but it took me like 13 years to figure it out, kind of sad. But then it was like ACC 2013, Romulo Barra, Carlos Estima and another Galvao match. So that was my trigger point. Because Galvao considered one of the best grapplers in the world, and Brawley also, and the match was usually on that. And so Brawley was on his back, did this, you know, rather she knows him. And Galvao was like, he was like, and then he went away, and what the hell? You know, that doesn't, Brawley didn't do anything, and Galvao was helpless. He tried a couple of times to pass, but Brawley spinned, and it was like kind of like playing with a kid. And they both, Galvao looked like a beginner. He's done jiu-jitsu for all his life, I guess. He looked like a beginner. I was like, it can't be that easy, you know. I jump more back, Gunnar Nelson drove me crazy, you know. When I was first in Ireland, maybe even 6-7 years ago, I saw Gunny first time, he did open guard. And it looked ridiculously easy. He just, nobody passed his guard. I had a really hard time guillotining me like Brazilian times. But he couldn't explain it. I tried to mimic him, but still I get card passed. But now I know how he does it. And now I can make everybody do it. And actually, just to jump ahead, it's been tested with Gunny. And Gunny actually asked, like, John, like, what are you doing? John was, you. now I can actually make it happen. And it's actually quite ridiculously simple to have a good open guard. And if you watch matches like Keenan Cornelius and Rafa Mendes training for ADCC, watch something. It's very simple what Rafa does. I just now understand how he does it. Before it just looked simple, but I couldn't mimic it because I didn't understand certain things. But it all happens when you have a question and you figure out the right question what to ask, then it's like, I just now see it. So before the question, you don't see it. That's kind of funny how I think everything works. So after Brawley, I started to play with that and then just build on. And actually last piece of the puzzle, like I guess some details coming more, but it was a week ago, or I think in Montana, or maybe 2 weeks ago, Montana, we kind of figured out underpasses that Joan actually raised a question in the Abercamp about what took the pass. And so it took me 1 month and a half to figure it out. I'm kind of obsessive about jiu-jitsu, can't you know, just always something, you know, they're working. So it took me 1.5 months to figure it out. The answer is ridiculously easy again. So, and I can show you how to do it, and most people can do it. if you have like if you have that kind of flexibility, that's already good. Because even playing open guard, I was stiff as hell. I can do this now. Playing open guard when I'm cold. And so I actually flexibility has gone up by playing open guard because body lets go to play that position a lot. So for I was stiff as hell, but now just magic when you do good jiu-jitsu. And also when you in my classes we use toes on the mat a lot. My squat has gone better because I end up doing squats all day when I squat. So all the natural flexibility that people have, like this flexibility what you know usually jiu-jitsu must have. It goes better by doing good jiu-jitsu. If you play toes on the mat side control, if you play grill chicken, this flexibility you will have. Better flexibility afterwards by just doing good jiu-jitsu. So to tease you, it's all about that question. Mostly everything is counted by this. And we only do one thing against all Brazilian passes. And then you have your doubts. Mm-hmm. It can't be that easy, but actually it is. So first we start to we call it bullseye drill. We start what grid chicken consists. We try to go. And this spin like going like towards partners, not away from partners. I couldn't do it before grid chicken. And now, because it was the hardest thing to teach to people, but now I can do it. I can do it 13 years, now I can do it by just understanding it. And it's one of the best defense moves turn towards a partner, but not away from partners. Okay, so first, what you have to do, grid chicken is like, we have 2 days also, so it, you get a little more. Knees wide, toes up. And you know, as much out you can, but not so, it's like tiring your legs. But knees wide, knees close to yourself, and this is like a boxing frame. And ideally, your arms are your footwork. So it's like boxing this. You have this, and you have your footwork, you know, you move, and then you start punching stuff, so you have this frame, it always stays there. The more you know boxing, you can box afterwards like this also, but you know, ideally it's here. And then your footwork. So you can't move in jiu-jitsu because your back's on the mat. So this is your guard and this is your footwork. You push from opponent to actually get Anis to move because he's there. That's your footwork actually. So it has to be like unmovable here. If you start to do those kind of things to explain, then you're gonna get passed. And most important, after 2 days, you will understand why passes work. That's the most also very important. Why you get passed? Then you can fix it. Because many years I didn't understand why passes happen. Now I understand what mistake I do, even smile most times. Because I know what they need. And also I call this those things I teach now, zero points. So before that there's no guard. And after that there's everything. So that's the zero point. So my knowledge, my goal as a coach, I think, is to give you a 0 point, that guard 0 point, nothing is before that. And then everything is a possibility. It's like explaining, you know, the evolution by natural selection of your darkness. Just all the complexity is explained by just simple theory. It boils down to one thing. So this is kind of the same stuff, like all the guards, the warm guards you see in Mundials right now, all the different spiders, it's all boils down. So in America, you use more, I guess, rotisserie chicken. But in Estonia, actually, grid chicken means rotisserie chicken. And rotisserie is kind of a weird name. In Estonia, it's a real gun, it's one word, actually. We don't split. So let's start with the drill, and then I give you more kind of philosophy for how it works. So your goal is to not move those legs and try to do like a 360 roll. So what I do is look like, this hand is kind of too short, you can't push your legs on the mat. Here. I couldn't do this 7 months ago, so I'm kind of enjoying myself. So, here. You can't use your, usually people want to put leg on the mat and then go to spin. It's kind of bad because you open up the space. Think about like boxing, like open up here, you get body punch, kick, whatever happens, you can just, you know, get punched. So, you have the defense. And you have to go over the log that kicks your butt up, actually. So It looks like really effortless, but when you start, it's going to be hard. So try it left to right, and then we go on. That's the first thing. That's the first thing.